everyone. Welcome back to Epic Beer Bros.
Oh, yes.
This was Black Belt.
Yes, this was recorded as part of the Epic Fest. This is the first of Haas's many games.
The Haas block.
Haas requested Black Belt for the Master System, and we thought, who better to invite on besides the usual? You got Alex, you got Brett, you got Gerard.
Shadow Ted.
We're all here. Ted is in the Shadow Realm. But we also brought Norm, the gaming historian, a fan favorite guest on Super Beard Bros.
It's true.
Hello.
Yeah, friend of the pod.
Hi.
Here we are.
This game? Are you like aware of this game and shit?
Yeah.
Like, cause you, yeah. All right, let's move on. Did you play this a lot or no?
No. I did not play this as a child. I'm just aware of it.
I understand. Have you ever played it? Have you ever gotten hands on?
I mean, I've never beaten it, but I have played it. This is actually a localized version of a Fist of the North Star game.
Dude, I saw him unloading the fucking Hotu Kono bullshit on that guy in the attract mode.
Yeah.
And I just thought it was an homage, but no, this is
Fist of the North Star, but not.
Got it.
That's so funny. I had no idea. One of the buttons on your face is definitely pause, Gerard.
Yeah,
is this Gerard playing right now? Okay.
It sure is.
Gerard is just jumping in and be like, catch up.
Foot. I can't. It's all I got.
So the things that fly above you.
Yeah.
You can like press down up and like get them.
This is like a really, really early beat 'em up.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Like, dude, like I was saying
Super
earlier,
jump.
What was it called? China Warrior on TurboGrafx?
Yep.
It really is like similar to that game. Like, except China Warrior, the sprite is like the size of like the final boss in most games.
Yeah.
So this game walks so that final fight can run.
Oh yeah, Kung Fu, very similar. I've only ever played that on PC. Isn't that weird?
That is very weird.
the square mouths.
Not to be confused, there was a Karate Kid game for the NES, wasn't there?
There was, published by LJN, and I think Atlas developed it.
Whoa.
What a weird time that was. Atlas game.
Yo, this guy's in. Oh, shit. Oh! Does he have sunglasses on?
He sure does, Alex.
That's how you know he's a cool guy.
What year is this? Oh, he's dead. Damn, you like handled that guy.
I'm the best!
You haven't been touched.
I got touched a little bit in the beginning.
This guy looks like Zarnov, or what's his name? Karnov?
Karnov, yeah.
Of Data East Revenge?
Yeah. Well, he's the mascot of Data East, I think, right? He has like his own games too, right?
And there's an NES Karnov game.
Yeah.
Oh shit, it's Wolverine.
Wolverine the Chinese clown.
Oh shit.
God, I hated that run when Wolverine was a Chinese clown.
He was like, "You done messed with me one too many times, bub. I'm a Chinese clown.
I'm a hopping vampire doing Peking opera, bub."
So I don't want any trouble.
So this game was originally on the Sega Mark III, which is pre-Master System. But it was localized for America on the Master System. And guess who programmed it?
Did you do it, Norm?
It was me.
Wow.
Dude.
No, it was Yuji Naka, Sonic the Hedgehog.
Holy shit.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah.
That's crazy. No wonder I loved this game.
No, wait a minute. I'm going to ask you this fight because this is amazing.
Okay.
I have questions for Norm after this.
All right. Yo, your sprite doubled in size. You have like a mouth now.
You know what? Yeah, if Alex is Miyamoto, then I'm Yuji Naka.
Yuji Naka, that adds up. Yeah,
you guys got to think different
when you're at a Texas convention and we're all there.
Yo, the jump ins. Fucking Tau Pai Pai over here.
Hat? No!
Yeah?
Get over here.
Yeah, play all footsies. Oh, look at the medium kick!
I'm dead.
Look at the medium kick!
I got a Japanese cousin named Riki. Riki Samundich.
I want to do the fucking Fate of Fury punches that they were doing in the fucking
the
track.
The North Star guy?
No. Not
I don't
those.
Know if it's in this version.
Fate of Fury.
That might only be a track screen stuff.
There's probably some secret, like, forward, back,
maybe
forward.
Maybe if you beat him, he does it. Maybe if you beat him, he just does it.
Fuck!
I gotta say, the colors are, like, lit on this. Like, I don't know that much about the Master System, because, like, literally no one that I know had one anywhere ever.
It was, pretty impressive. Like, I remember the Ghostbusters game looks pretty good on the Master System compared to the NES version.
It's like the NES one?
It plays very similarly, but the graphics look way better, if I recall.
Well, I mean, that's pretty much all that I need.
That's all you need, right?
Graphics?
Yo, this man gets frame priority over me.
That He's just longer kick than you. Is buff, dude.
I have one punch and one kick, no variants. I can do a jump kick, and that's about it. I'm dead. Game over.
Let's run it back, man. Now, here's my question for you, Norm. Did you okay. like, surprise me with the amount of trivia that you know for this game. Did you know that already, or did you, like, know that we were going to play this today, and you're like, let me look up a little bit?
You know, it's just something I remember reading when I was doing research for, honestly, I can't even remember what I was doing research for, but it was like, oh, and Yuji Naka, one of his first games was Black Belt, and I think it's the foot on the cover. It's the cover art for this game. I always remember it.
Got it.
There's another one that's like a dude holding a dude's head. He's like, there's like another Master System game. I forget what it is, but it's like some dude is like
pro wrestling.
Yeah, it's like just holding, his own head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be like in a headlock, I guess. But it's his own head. Am I invincible?
Maybe you have like a power up right now.
I can't tell.
He's starting to believe you guys.
These guys just blow apart into pieces.
They always told me that I was going to fall in love with somebody who could turn men into jigsaw puzzle pieces.
Maybe. I wonder if you had more health than the game could show.
Oh, that's weird. That's a thought.
These are like Lord Zedd buddies. Remember them?
Yuji Naka was a terrible programmer.
Dude, he sucks, dude. Lazy.
Broken game. Unplayable.
Oh. Do you have a crouching attack in this mode?
I think you can, yeah.
There you go.
It looks like it like doesn't go farther out than his hands. Oh.
This is the same guy as the chef guy throwing knives. He's just changed shirts.
He kind of looks like the dude from Gundam, you know, the fucking like main dude, the bad guy.
Well, there's Char? A lot of Gundams. Oh, Char?
Yeah.
Sure.
I guess a little bit.
I can see
it's like, I mean, like I Master mean, System.
Maybe from like Char's counterattack. Yeah. I don't know about there you go. OG Char.
I didn't know that you were like the guy who was going to do the deep pulls on the Gundam. I guess not that deep.
Sorry, I'm a big Gundam fan.
Is that right?
Is that a new Netflix thing?
Huh.
Yeah.
Is that a new Netflix thing or is that like before pandemic you were fully into
this
Gundam?
This was a young Norm running home from school to watch Toonami Gundam fan.
I remember Gundam Wing. I remember that.
Yeah, I was in Gundam Wing super hard back
then. That
was the
one that I think a lot of us, our first exposure to that. I remember watching that series and being like, these teenagers are really suicidal. It seemed like every other episode they were like, I'm going to kill myself.
Oh, you were watching Evangelion.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah. My pick for Gundam is 8th MS Team. That's what I always tell people.
I remember that one. Yeah.
Do you love 8th MS Team? My favorite is 0080.
Oh, another excellent Gundam show.
Yes. There's a lot of good Gundam series.
Yeah, it really is like quite excellent. Look at this fucking guy. No eyes, just like a brow.
That's about as fast as I'd be taken out in a fight like that. Yeah.
you'd wear your nice big silk. I would wear that
because I know that's the suit I'm going to be buried in.
Well, better dressed to the nines.
Oh, try to give him a few kicks.
Drink that embalming liquid there.
Ew.
What the fuck, bro?
He's got that Waluigi kick. Look at him.
Dude. He like, I kick him, he gets kicked back, and he gets iframes.
Standing medium kick is no joke. This is it, baby. Let's figure out how to beat this guy. Whip punish. All day.
You've got him. You just gotta stay out of there and then get in there.
Footsies, baby. Whiff punish.
He does way more damage than you do.
Oh my god, he's such a dirty computer.
Home prancing kick.
There should be like a show where people just fight all those like stupid ass bosses.
I think Maximilian's got a show like that.
Oh yeah.
I think it's Boss Rage?
Yeah, that's a great idea.
I love that show.
All those dumbass unfair bosses.
You think this guy should be on there?
I mean, if this is the boss of chapter one, I don't even want to think about what the last boss of Kung Fu or Black Belt is like. Sorry, super fans.
Actually, it's Black Belt.
Dude, somebody.
Is this black belt for the master system?
Somebody, you caught yourself. Somebody was cracking their knuckles getting ready to unload in the comments.
Oh, yeah.
They're already unloading.
I see what you got going on, Gerard. I see what you got going on.
You call yourself the gaming historian? Ugh. Cringe.
And their keyboard out of like.
Hi, Norm. I'm a big fan. What follows are 9 pages of ways I think your show can be better.
Oh, I'd love to see that.
There was a guy. What was it? I forget exactly what the situation was, but he sent in like dimes.
Oh, yes.
What was the deal with that?
There was a guy who wrote me a letter saying that he uses ad block. He doesn't believe in supporting creators. Cool. But he wanted to support me, so he basically gave me what he believed to be the value of my videos. So he gave me $2.10 for 3 or 4 videos.
Yep.
So I got $10.
Cool.
And $10 and actually $11. No, $10.50 is what he's. I forget what it was.
It was doesn't like matter. A weird amount of money.
Yeah, and then he wrote several like things notes. About. Yeah, like what he doesn't like about the show.
You know, like actual specific critiques on specific episodes.
Hyper specific stuff.
And it got to the point where he started writing multiple letters. So like I thought it was over after the first one.
Did he keep sending you money?
Yes, he did.
Like a couple cents here and there for every video that he watched and his thoughts.
And if you're watching, hey, thank you for the $20. I'm okay. Hold on to it.
Yeah, dude,
it was incredible reading those notes, man. Like the pathology of a person like that is fascinating.
It gave us all a great laugh.
Well, it's like,
hey, you'll never forget it, right?
Yeah.
Definitely.
He wanted to make memories for you. That's what he was doing.
Yeah, that's what that guy who shot John Lennon said too.
Hey, YOLO.
Oh, shit. Thank you for spending money on this episode, Haas. We really appreciate you. Oh, sushi!
Oh, that's what you needed.
The worst part is, like, for the joke, I didn't remember his name, but I know his name is Mark David Chapman.
Really?
The John Lennon guy? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
His plan totally worked.
So what kind of feedback did this guy have for you?
He said I wasn't funny and I should stop trying to be funny.
Okay.
Bolt. I should consider replacing having a number two on the show.
Okay.
Because me as a straight man just quote unquote doesn't work.
Wait. What?
yeah, break that down.
Yeah, like me as like the show doesn't work with just one guy. According to this gentleman,
so you need someone else.
I need a sidekick to make the show entertaining.
Oh, okay.
He's saying that really what the completionist was all about was the other guy.
Right. Oh. Even though these letters were very recent, and those videos haven't been online for about 4 years now. So
yeah. Didn't he have some like delivery notes on some jokes or something like that?
He gave me vocal. He gave me
like how to read a line.
A line. He gave me how to pronunciate some words because my pronunciation was incorrect.
Oh yeah.
I love that your foot is too far ahead.
It sounds like some great feedback.
Norm, was that you? Norm, is that you the whole time?
Norm, if you wanted really the feedback, useful. Buddy, you could just text to me.
That guy seems to agree with me about your cadence during your joke telling. That's so weird. I also value your show at a similar monetary amount.
What a coincidence. We feel the exact same way.
That guy's got some pretty great ideas.
I'd vote for him.
Oh!
Why are these two guys like so easy, and then the next guy's like Waluigi, and he's like impossible.
Purple.
He looks like he's from like a different game. He looks like he's from like Tingles, like weird DS game.
Sometimes people just want to be heard in that way, though. You know, like that guy who said the money. Like he just
Some people are just completely out of.
They're just in their own zone.
Yeah,
and they're trying to.
Look at this dude. Look at his legs. They're like horse legs.
Get out of here.
They bend backwards at the knee like a horse.
Well, maybe he just has a problem, you guys. Lay off him. Jeez.
Oh.
I meant the fat guy.
Oh, that guy?
Yeah,
I'm not worried about
that. Not the guy who wrote the letters. I meant the fat guy.
He died with honor. Don't worry about him. He's good.
Yo, that
moonwalk. Dressed to the nines.
Oh.
Imagine being so hyped that you're going to kill a man that you jump on the balls of your feet up and down to get around.
That's just his fighting stance. He's ready to go.
Dude, he's so good at fighting.
Fighting game, you have anti-airs. The medium kick is not an anti-air.
I see you've studied Spaz style.
Every time he does the T-pose, I think he's gonna put his hands together.
Dude,
like
me too.
Smash your face.
That jump kick is like the thing. That's the thing that's getting...
I want to get back to this guy sending you money.
Yeah.
Did you deposit it into the account or what did you do with it?
I left it in the envelope.
Not so you didn't deduct it from, you didn't report it on your taxes, is what you're saying?
No, I did not.
Interesting.
I did not report it on my taxes.
Oh, well.
You heard it
here first,
folks.
Sounds like a confession.
Yep.
We may have used some of it to buy trash bags or pencils or something. Oh. Hey, that's actually not...
You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of when you're watching a Twitch streamer and someone will donate to say, you suck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, I guess thanks for giving
thanks
me
for
money
watching.
To tell me I suck.
Thank you for watching and engaging
it's
with
like,
my content.
Great prank, bro. You got me.
Yeah, that's just a natural evolution of the same thing where people will watch your show continually to hate on it, even if it's in their heads.
It's like a hate watch, yeah.
Yeah, which is look, man, I understand you're not enjoying it, but thanks for the free real estate inside your head, I guess. Same thing as saying thanks for the money, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The weirdest part about that is that I have high school friends who do that to me.
How do you know that? People, are they friends? If they're
They were my closest friends in high school. I was very close with them. And I found out that at a recent party that I was not invited to, they put on my videos to then laugh at how I would pronunciate words and do phrases. And
How did you find that out?
Because one of them told me that's what they did.
So,
and I was like, great. And I'm cutting all these people out. No, he was mad because he was like, why are we making fun of Gerard? He's our friend.
Oh, I see.
And they were like, oh, it's all in good goofs. And it's like, well, you watched for several hours and you made fun of me the whole time.
And these are adults?
Yes, these are people who I grew up with in high school.
It's fucked up.
People who I spent 5 to 6 years with, a friendship through good times and hard times. People who I, were brothers. Like, they were very close to me. And I found that out, and I was like, great. I guess I will be on my island now. Thank you.
Well, to be clear, I have a couple notes for my brother, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, he's just, he could work on his delivery a little bit. You know what I mean? I get the jokes, but it's not the same when you don't say it right.
Yeah, that's true. You're right.
Honestly, I've been kind of holding my tongue on this, but I wouldn't mind seeing you lift some more weights in the middle of your videos, too.
Oh, okay, yeah. I appreciate it. Yeah, I'll be sure to...
Take a break from VO. Get over there and pump some iron.
Just some dumbbells DDR. While you're, on screen, you know?
You know, you're Brett, what a great recommendation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I'm here for.
I should really just listen to everyone's ideas all the time.
Yeah.
That would make the show way better if you just took everyone's ideas and just made it happen.
That's what we're here for, you know? Listening to other people tell us what they want us to do.
Yeah. Oh!
Imagine being the general of this army and looking out on these, buff, bald mustache guys.
Can you imagine just telling, the report? Sir, the whole army's down. How many did they lose? Zero. How many did we lose? 50.
All of them, sir.
What do you mean they broke? Exploded. Their bones broke? What do you mean? What?
Every last man, a fucking porcelain vase,
just
sir.
Burst them and they exploded. They burst into pixels.
Also, sir, it's 35 degrees, sir. Do you think maybe we could throw on a little t-shirt?
The cold makes you strong. Also,
they're launching
apparently.
Sushi onto the battlefield. It's artillery.
It's meant for the bad guys. He's like, stop eating. That's not for you. That's for them.
Our troops are getting hungry, General. Send the giant shrimp sushi.
We must communicate. Quick, Send Japanese kanji.
Sir, I'm here. Please, I'm not here to fight. Oh.
It's not working. Send in the one fat guy.
The one fat guy. Only him.
Those neutral jumps are really doing the most business, man.
Yeah, yeah, I think the jump kicks.
That's the move.
This guy's name is Ryu.
Dude, he's so much cooler. He's like the Jesus compared to Ryu.
Oh,
you know.
What if he's the final boss?
What if he's the final boss? He has no counter to this.
Trying to do some neutral jump bullshit on me, man? No way, man.
I don't think so. No way.
You try that neutral jump on me, I snap your foot out of the air and shove it up your ass.
I kick you 6 times without bending my goddamn knee.
Oh god, the footsie game! No!
He's like, did someone say footsie? Oh fuck.
He just gets free iframes to dance around.
He's dead.
Nobody beats the Jesus, man.
Nobody beats the Jesus.
All right, this is it.
Are we going to get past chapter 1?
Final fight. This is the final fight.
This is the final fight. This is our final chance.
I'm so sorry, Haas. I failed you, my friend.
Wait, this isn't what Haas wanted?
This is what he wanted us to play the game, I guess.
Yeah.
But I really wanted to at least get past stage 1.
At least beat Ryu. Well, this would be a summer. I would play this game. This seems fun.
Oh, interesting. That was an interesting strategy. Like,
he could just do the can-can.
Like, short jump, jump kick, and then you jump away, like, immediately after. Yeah. That looked pretty interesting.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Let's go till game over, and then we'll wrap.
Ooh.
Very carefully wrap.
Oh, yeah. We got to very, very carefully wrap in case the entire setup explodes. Which it did earlier today. Oh, look at that.
This seems to be working pretty well.
Yo, this short hop situation is working.
Yo, look at them sex kicks.
You got that life lead.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, look at how fast he closes the gap. Oh my god.
Yeah, get your fucking can-can out of here. Cross-ups, homie, cross-ups. And this dude's corpse hopping like Blanca, I hate it.
Yeah, I really
don't
like
it. Don't get greedy.
Imagine if this was a fighting game at like Evo.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna make this happen. Side tournament, let's go.
One player.
This is insane. Yo!
Yeah!
There we go.
Oh my god.
Let's go!
Annihilated. Can it get better than that?
Fucking
that
epic.
Was the only way to end this stream.
Yeah, we're
There's
done.
There's the end this video.
Yeah.
Screw chapter 2. That was the perfect way.
Wow.
I love that.
Wow.
So good. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Norm, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for coming on and helping us raise some money for charity. Just good vibes all around.
Guys, absolutely. I'm in New York going to Madison Square Garden fighting all of Vince McMahon's 80s wrestler army.
Every Ultimate Warrior fan in New York City is here. All right. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching.
They jump now.
Go check out Norm on The Gaming Historian.
Check out his video on the U-Force, you guys. It's great.
Yeah. Seriously, it's the most comprehensive videos.
Besides your channel, games. Norm, is there anything else that you want to plug and let people know that you're doing?
I don't think so.
All right.
YouTube is it. That's it.
That's the future.
Do you
it's
have
the
any,
future.
Like notes or feedback notes for people watching this video?
Well, I want you to take note of how Gerard fought that first boss.
Mm.
Yeah.
And just don't do what he did.
Yeah.
Think twice, guys.
Think twice.
Guys, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you guys next time on another F It Beard Bros. See you around.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Peach.